Hi everyone, my name is Kenny Coleman and I am a Senior Technical Marketing Manager at VMware. In this video, we are going to look at the setup and configuration of a private harbor registry using vSphere with Tanzu. vSphere with Tanzu has a new feature that allows Tanzu Kubernetes clusters to be provisioned that will automatically trust certificates used for private container registries. This is important because many container registries are created using private or self-signed certificates. A standard Kubernetes node will reject pulling images without trusted certificates, and you'll be met with an error such as X509, certificate signed by unknown authority. A way around this would be manually installing the certificate on every Kubernetes node to pull from the registry, but that's manual, and a rolling update would break this configuration because the certificate would have to be reinstalled on every new Kubernetes node that gets deployed. With this new feature, the certificates are automatically configured for any new Tanzu Kubernetes cluster, and the configuration persists over a Kubernetes update. For this demonstration, we'll be using Harbor as our container registry. Harbor is an open source registry that is a graduated project in the Cloud Native Computing Foundation. Harbor comes with many enterprise features, such as role-based access control, image vulnerability scanning, proxy caching for things like Docker Hub rate limiting, and much more. Harbor comes with VMware support when attached to any Tanzu Edition license and can be deployed in a few different ways. In this demonstration, we will deploy Harbor using the Helm chart. Before we can configure Harbor, we need a new Tanzu Kubernetes cluster to deploy Harbor to. Here's a simple manifest for a Tanzu Kubernetes cluster using one control plane node and two workers. Setting a default storage class is required for Harbor's Helm chart deployment to successfully complete. Let's apply this manifest to the vSphere namespace and wait for the deployment to complete. For production environments, consider using three control plane nodes and more workers, plus larger machine classes. While the cluster is being created, let's get Harbor prepared. Add the Harbor Helm repo and then fetch and untar the Harbor Helm chart. The file we need is the values.yaml, and there are only four lines in here that need to be adjusted. Another new feature in vSphere Tanzu with Update 2 is the ability to set static IPs with the service type of load balancer. However, this only works when using the NSX Advanced Load Balancer services, which was formerly known as AVI Networks, or NSXT. You can choose any IP from the load balancer pool that can be applied to Harbor. First, we're going to edit the type to be load balancer. Then, under TLS, then auto and common name, we're going to change that to be the IP address or the fully qualified domain name. Under the load balancer section, we're going to change the IP to the chosen IP address that we want to be able to take from the load balancer pool. Lastly, we're going to edit the external URL to be the IP address or the fully qualified domain name of the Harbor instance. In a production environment, consider increasing the storage sizes for persistent volumes and using a highly available PostgreSQL and Redis database. After the Harbor Tanzu Kubernetes cluster is ready, we can authenticate to it. In a production environment, set proper role binding so that containers can be created with correct permissions. In a test or demo environment such as this, running the following command will negate pod security privileges and allow anyone authenticated to the cluster to deploy containers. And now we can use Helm to install Harbor. The process only takes a few minutes as the containers get downloaded and moved into a running state. The IP address we specified in the values.yaml gets created as a Kubernetes service, and we can also see this in the NSX ALB interface that a new load balancer has now been provisioned. We can navigate to the IP address, and we're presented with a self-signed certificate to accept, and we can log into Harbor with the default admin account and password. The next step is editing the vSphere with Tanzu configuration to trust the private registry certificates that have been generated. This happens at the namespace level, so change your kubectl config to use the context of the namespace. Getting the private registry certificate is fairly straightforward. Using the OpenSSL sclientconnect command to the IP or the fully qualified domain name of the Harbor instance with port 443. We will copy the portion where it shows begin all the way to end certificate with the trailing hyphens. Now we need to base64 encode the certificate value onto a single line. I've discovered the best way to do this is using the text to base64 encoder on base64.guru. Now we're going to edit the running TKG service configuration file with kubectl. Use the external private registry configuration from the documentation for easily copying and pasting and adding the new trust fields, which will configure any new Tanzu Kubernetes cluster to automatically trust any certificate we place here. The name of the trusted CA can be anything, but for this instance, I use the name of the Tanzu Kubernetes cluster, which is called Harbor. Then we need to paste our single line Base64 encoded certificate in the data section. Now we're going to save the running configuration with write quit. Now the hard part is complete, so let's test it out. Create a new Tanzu Kubernetes cluster, which now will inherit the trusted CA certificates that we had just configured with inside of the TKG service configuration. And while the cluster is creating, we can prepare our first image to be pulled from the registry. Your local machine cannot talk to the newly deployed Harbor instance because it's an untrusted registry. However, we can add it to our trusted insecure registry section in the Docker engine configuration by specifying the IP or the fully qualified domain name if you have DNS running in your environment. We can apply it and then restart the Docker engine. Once restarted, we can use the Docker login to verify that we can communicate with the new Harbor registry. Now on my local machine, we're going to use the Docker engine to pull the latest nginx image directly from Docker Hub. In Harbor, let's create a new public project called Tanzu. Harbor has taken a lot of the guesswork out of this by giving us all the commands required to push images to this repository. The first thing we'll need to do is tag our nginx image that we just pulled from Docker Hub with the IP or the fully qualified domain name of the project name, which is Tanzu, and the image name and the tag, which I've specified as nginx v1. Once that is done, I can simply use the Docker push command with the new tag, and it will be pushed to the Harbor instance. Once the image is pushed to Harbor, we can manually kick off a Trivi vulnerability scan, or we can wait until it automatically does it at a set time that will look for critical vulnerability exploits if we wanted to address them at this time. We can check and see that our new cluster is up and running, and we're ready to authenticate to it. After authenticating, we change our context to the desired cluster, and we want to disable pod security privileges once again. Now we can create a new deployment that specifies the image in the Harbor registry, and we can see that the container is now in a creating state. By putting a describe on the pod, we can see that the image was successfully pulled from Harbor and the container has started. We can also expose this deployment by using another service type of load balancer. This service will pull an IP from the pool that was specified in NSX ALB, and we can see that in the NSX ALB user interface. Once we navigate to that IP address, we can see that the Nginx web server is running and available. Another great feature of Harbor is the ability to use it as a proxy cache, meaning that if someone requests an image from a configured project or repository, and it doesn't exist, it will fetch it from a configured public or private repository and then cache it for anybody else that wants to then pull from it. So let's use Docker Hub as an example, because they are now doing rate limiting on Docker Hub pulls per hour from anonymous accounts, as well as putting a cap on registered accounts as well. To do this, create a new registry endpoint, specifying Docker Hub as the provider. And optionally, you can enter your Docker Hub credentials to allow more pulls than anonymous users would be allowed, and let's press OK. Now we can create a new project that will be configured only as a proxy cache by turning on the proxy cache button and specifying the registry endpoint that we had just created. We want to use a specific image for Nginx this time, such as stable Alpine. From the command line, we can create another deployment specifying the Harbor registry repository. And since we're using an official Docker Hub image, we need to specify library as the project name. We finish it with the Nginx tag, and after a few seconds, we can see that the Nginx image has successfully been pulled from Docker Hub to Harbor and then pulled into our Kubernetes cluster. Going into the Harbor interface, we can see that the artifact SHA for the cached image is different than the SHA that was previously uploaded to Harbor that was in the latest Nginx image. So, we do know it's working just as expected. I hope you enjoyed this demonstration of using a private Harbor registry with Tanzu Kubernetes clusters as a part of vSphere Tanzu. Please make sure you always refer to the documentation for all the latest updates to this feature.